Guys, this is your girl Simply Betty coming to you with just a short video of something that's been on my mind for the last couple of days. And it's not necessarily something that I've recently had a conversation about. Maybe I have. But it's about your kids, basically. You know, sometimes I talk to parents and they say, oh, we don't do nothing, we don't go nowhere because, you know, taking the kids out is a lot of hassle and it costs so much money. But take them doggone kids out of the house. My thing is, the only way your child is going to learn how to behave in public is if you take them out in public and show them how to behave. Now, I'm not saying beat your kids. I'm not saying take them to the most expensive restaurants, but you can take them out in public. You gotta show your kids how to act in public. Okay, you show them how to act in public, they do it correctly, then you can make it a family day and just have fun with it. As you can see, my son back there demolishing that ice cream. He didn't have no chance. We've been cooped up in the house for the last 2 days, potty training. He's been driving me crazy. I've been driving him crazy. But you know what? I said, you know what? I'm going to take him out the house today. Today is going to be Rome's day. Today we're going to do whatever. I know that it's fun for my son. And it didn't even cost me that much money. Chuck E. Cheese has it to where, I don't know about all the Chuck E. Cheeses, but I know the Chuck E. Cheese in our area, they have it to where they can play for a time. So they can play however many games they want. They just have a certain time limit to play those games, which is very beneficial to me, because if I want him to play for an hour, hey, I just go buy a card, put an hour long time limit on there, and let him go to town. He have fun. I'm having fun watching him having fun, because it's keeping him occupied. I know where he's at. I know what he's doing. He's having fun. When he's done, he'll take a nap, and we're good. We go to a restaurant. Now, see, I take my child to restaurants. I will say that. I do take my toddler to restaurants. I don't know who this is calling me, but I take my child to restaurants. And the reason I do that is so that he will know how to act in public. Let me tell you something. The first time my child said thank you to a waitress for bringing him his food. Now, he's only 2. He won't be 3 until February. But the lady set his food down and he literally said thank you. Now, I wasn't teaching him to say thank you. It's all right, baby. Hi. He doesn't like mess on him. It's all right. You wasting it. Give me some. This is what you got to deal with. Hey, it's all right. Here. Clean it up. Now, I wasn't necessarily teaching him how to say thank you when people brought him stuff. What I was doing was, every time I gave him something or he handed me something that I asked him to, I would say thank you. And in return, he just picked up to say thank you, which is a very good manner to teach a child. Oh, clean your hands. Look on your arm. Clean your arm. But you know, it's a good thing. It teaches him early on. He may not know the meaning of thank you, but he knows, okay, this is just something that I say anytime I do something or give somebody something or somebody gives me something. I say thank you. Okay, baby, mama gonna get it. And you know, let me turn this down. And I just don't understand how parents can just feel like their child is so difficult. children are not difficult. They're really not. They're very wonderful people. They're little people, and they're hard at communicating things because they haven't learned everything. Think about it. If you start a new job or something, you get a little bit overwhelmed because you have to learn and take up all this training and learn all these new things and learn how things work at this company. You go about it differently, but eventually you get it. Same thing with children. You can't just expect them to know things right out the gate. They're not. You have to teach them. That's right, baby. Gate. Tell them. Gate. Yeah. You know, you got to teach them. You got to show them what they're supposed to be doing. And for those of you who think y'all not good role models, let me tell you something. Everybody is not perfect. Everybody don't raise their kids perfectly. Take that pressure off of yourself. If it's something that you don't know, find somebody that does know. Or look it up yourself. Learn to be a good parent. Make sure you're doing things correctly. Because if you send your child down the wrong path, I'm telling you, it's going to end up very badly for your child or yourself or both or somebody else. It's not going to end up very well, basically. So, that was just my little venting session. A, take them damn kids out the house. Show them some fun. It ain't got to be expensive fun. You can take them to the park. If you don't feel like going nowhere, if your car broke down, if you got a water hose or a little kiddie pool, you can go to Family Dollar and Dollar General to get some little cool toys and stuff for kids to play with. If you got $10 to spare, you got 5 kids, I guarantee you there's a lot of stuff that you can do with that $10. You can go to Dollar Tree, get you some popsicles, you know, or something. Dollar Tree sell groceries. Dollar Tree sell toys and stuff that you can play with your kids. You ain't got to be rich to show your kids things, you know, just be thoughtful, basically. If you take care of your kids, I guarantee you your kids are going to take care of you when you get older. That's something that my dad has said while I was growing up. You know, I forgot who he was talking to or what the conversation was about. And basically the person was just like, oh, I got to make sure my kids do this, this, and this, and this, so they can. And my dad literally stopped them and said, if you take care of your kids while they're young, you don't have to worry about that because they're going to take care of you when they get up, when you get old. And that is completely true. You see parents out here in these nursing homes and stuff, maybe your kid's not able to take care of you physically. Or maybe there's too much stuff going on. You know, I mean, I don't, everybody's situation is different, but I know for me, none of our parents is going to nursing homes. We ain't having it. None of them. Mother-in-laws, father-in-laws, on both sides, on all sides. Nobody going in no nursery home. We won't play them games. Our parents took care of us. And in turn, we're going to take care of them when they need it. So, stretch your dollars. Entertain your kids. Because I guarantee you, your kids are going to be grateful. Now, if your kids act up and they not grateful, well then, you ain't got to do it. Simple as that. But try to do something that's very educational and fun for your children. They learn things from what their environments. Don't let the world raise your child. You raise your children. So that's really all I wanted to say. I was just doing a little venting session. You tying your shoes? You tying your shoes? No? I'm going to give y'all a close-up. I want y'all to see his face. Like, you see a little bit, but I need you to see his face. Ooh, look at that face. Got ice cream all on it. Ooh. But, yeah. So, today has been about Rome. Mommy has spent $30. You got an hour's worth of playtime at the arcade. And $10 on food. $2 on ice cream. So,
Yeah, about $30 worth. And he's headphones. And it is gonna be 4 o'clock. So yeah, I'm about to go back to the house. Maybe we might do something else. I might let him just go outside later on, play with the neighborhood kids. Something that'll knock him out for the rest of the day. Maybe. I don't know. I'm feeling a little festive today. Y'all see my little ponytail? I could pull my hair in a ponytail at the top. I could pull it in a ponytail at the back too, but, you know, didn't feel like it. Anyways, that was my little venting session. Y'all have to excuse my face. Like I said, it's fun day, so I didn't put on no makeup. I was not trying to be sweating out here in this Texas heat. I don't know who pissed summer off, but damn, it is hot. So that's all I wanted to say to you guys. Hit that subscribe button, hit the notification bell, share, comment. I do respond to my comments, reasonable comments. Any support, I do appreciate my subscribers that I do have now, and I appreciate my future subscribers going forth. This is your girl, Simply Betty 101, and you guys have a good day.